commission and the federal board. Just to let you know that we are moving on. So one of the things we do is consult with artists from across different art forms. And Martin Sawtell, who's here today, actually does a lot of consultation. And so we've learned things from the artists and what skills they want to develop and stuff as well. And one of the things we found, listening to artists, but also listening to the funding bodies about when they get grant applications from artists, visual artists in particular, is that artists really need to understand things like an artist statement, an artist biography, how to document your work. So there are all those really practical business things that you need to do to be able to be competitive and put yourself out there as an artist and work like other artists. So we thought we really need to support all the fabulous visual artists we know to do something like this, and that's how Armature was born. And the other thing we've found a lot too is that we have a number of artists coming in saying, how can I get my work framed? Well, there's no money, you know, to get work framed just put on walls. We can't advise them to do that. And that's my phone. Excuse me, everybody, if you stop. And we really wanted to open up people's mind about what art is, that art isn't just about putting, making a piece of work in two-dimensional form and putting it in a frame on a wall, that art is much more than that. And whether that's the style you work in, how looking at other forms can affect your work. So that's really why we did it. And we've got some fantastic artists in South Australia. I'm just going to mention all the names that we're in this project. And maybe they're just going to stand up and meet me before I thank other people. Adam Martin. Do you want to come up, Adam? Just so everyone can see. Well, some of your...
Okay.
Joanne Chu. Lawrence Woods. Mandy Flynn. James Kirks. So you have to document for this way, James. Sophia Borick. And Michael Hammerstein. Ben. So Ben's a fantastic artist that took on this project, and I've been on leave, so I haven't been around to really see anything, but kept hearing fantastic feedback from people like Lara Tor, who I've been working with. The other people we really need to thank are Kirsty Martinson, who's the coordinator of this project, Lara Tor, who is one of the artists involved, and Lara can't be with us because she's just flew out to London last night to go and work with Vocal Eyes on audio description because she's an audio scriber. And Sasha Gerbic. I just said to Sasha. So, who was one of the other artists involved? And we've had two of the best artist curators in South Australia working on this project. So, thanks to them. We've also had a fantastic team of Auslan interpreters that Access to Arts wants to work with. Pip, Adrian, Amber, I'm not sure who else came in during this process, but thanks to them as well for getting what we do and supporting us to support deaf artists. And we need to thank the Arts SA Richard Llewellyn Arts and Disability Trust for funding this project. They've been great supporters of us, and thanks to them. And thank you to everyone that's come to witness this work today. I came in not knowing what to expect, and I've been very excited. And lots of things have resonated with me. So well done, everyone, and particularly the artists.
Mick.
Sorry. Mick for filming, documenting the work.
Thanks, Mick.
Thank you, everybody. Enjoy.
Thank you, Gail. No worries. Thank you. Good job.
Thank you, Chris.
No worries.